Hello everyone, the topic for now is price elasticity of demand, and price elasticity of demand is the responsiveness of quantity demand to a change in price. And price elasticity of demand is calculated using formula percentage change in quantity demand divided by percentage change in price. So another formula for this is change in quantity demand over change in price into P1 over Q1. So you can use any one of these and both will give exactly same answer. So I'm going to discuss question number 3 here now. And question number 3 says the diagram for the demand for a product is known as price elastic. Demand is elastic when the answer of PED is greater than 1, keep in mind, and it would be inelastic if it is less than 1. So since in this question examiner is saying that price elastic demand is there, so it means the answer would be greater than 1. Okay, so which fall in quantity demanded could follow a 10% price rise? It means ke if demand is elastic, our answer should be greater than 1, and change in price is 10%, so change in quantity must be more than 10%. If change in price is 10%, quantity demand must be more than 10%. For example, if we take 0%, then 0% divided by 10% is equal to 0, and then similarly 5% over 10% is equal to 0.5, that is again less than 1. 10% over 10% will be equal to 1, that is again less than, that is not greater than 1. So 15% over 10% will give us 1.5, which is greater than 1. So option D is correct answer, and you can choose option D. Okay, so now moving to question number 6. Question number 6 says there are a fixed number of seats at a concert. Most of the audience would continue to attend even if seats price were increased. It means ke demand for seats would be inelastic, relatively inelastic. In option A, you can see that demand is perfectly elastic, so we can cross it. And in case of B, it is perfectly inelastic, again we can cross it, because we need inelastic, relatively inelastic. In case of relatively inelastic demand, demand curve is always steeper. For a quick review, I can let you know that demand, when it is steep like this, it would be inelastic, and if it is flat like this, this would be elastic, and whenever it is a vertical straight line, it would be perfectly inelastic, and when it is horizontal straight line, it would be perfectly elastic. So it means we have to find out steeper demand curve. So steeper demand curve is this one, and this is flatter demand curve. We can cross the option as well. And again, question also says that there are a fixed number of seats in concert. It means ke supply of seats will be perfectly inelastic if it is fixed. So fixed supply is in option C. So fixed supply is when supply curve is vertical straight line. It means ke quantity will remain at this level whatever price is there. So option C is correct answer. Now moving to question number 8. The graph drawn to the same scale show the demand curves for 4 firms. The demand, the market price is $10. The price then falls to $8. Which firm will have the largest increase in total revenue? So keep in mind, whenever price falls, total revenue will increase only when demand is elastic, because a smaller fall in price will lead to greater rise in quantity demand. So as a result, total revenue will increase. So demand must be elastic. We can see, start from option D. Option D is positively sloped, while demand curve is always negatively sloped. Yes, exceptional case is there, that is Giffen and Veblen-Wood case, but that is not basically discussed in O levels. So option D is not correct. Option C is perfectly inelastic demand. In case of perfectly inelastic demand, if we want to increase total revenue, we should increase the price, but in this case price is decreasing from 10 to 8. So this is not correct answer. And option B is relatively steeper curve. In case of steeper curve, demand is less elastic or inelastic. And in case of inelastic, if price falls, total revenue also decreases. And the last option, and that is correct option, is option A. This is flatter demand curve, and in case of flatter demand curve, demand is relatively elastic. And when demand is elastic, a little fall in price will lead to greater rise in quantity demand. So as a result, total revenue will increase. So option A is correct, because examiner is asking in which case total revenue will increase. Now coming to question number 9, the table shows the value of price elasticity of demand for 4 products. The first one is cars, elasticity is equal to 2.0. Then is mobile phones equal to 1, radio equal to 0.5, and then salt 0.1. Okay, what would have an increase in sale revenue if prices rose by 10%? So it means that you have to identify the product for which revenue will increase if there is rise in price. So price rise increases revenue only when demand is inelastic or perfectly inelastic. So it means that in case of inelastic demand, the value of PED is always lesser than 1. So you can see that elasticity values are lesser than 1 in last two options, 0.5 and 0.1, radio and salt. It means that radios and salt are the two products the revenue from which will increase if there is increase in 10% increase in price. So we will choose option C. Okay, so the last question of this video. When the price of a product rises from $10 to $15, the demand falls from 5,000 to 4,000 units. What is the value of price elasticity of demand for the product? Price elasticity of demand is calculated as change in quantity demand. Delta sign shows change. Change in quantity demand over change in price into P1 over Q1. P1 is initial price and Q1 is initial quantity. So change in quantity here is 1,000. So we will put value 1,000. Change in price is 5. 10 to 15 is 5. Multiply by initial price was 10. And initial quantity was 5,000. So we can put the values and we can find final answer. So we can cross these three figures with zeros, with three zeros. So okay, so by further solving it, we have the value 10 over 5 into 5 is equal to 25. So 10 over 25 is equal to 0.4. So 0.4 is the correct option, option B. So this is it for today's class, and I will be explaining you further in next video, that is price elasticity of supply.